Hi, I'm Robert McNish. I'm an applications engineer at uBlox. Today, I'm going to give an introduction to the C99 F9P application board. So this board is the main evaluation platform for the Zed F9P module, which is the latest high-precision GNSS receiver from uBlox. Zed F9P is a multi-constellation, multi-band RTK receiver capable of position accuracy down to the centimeter. Now, if you're familiar with RTK receivers, you know that they need to either receive a stream of correction data if they're a rover, or transmit a stream of correction data if they're a base. And to make this easy, the board also includes a uBlox Odin W2 Bluetooth and Wi-Fi module. Using the Odin module, it's possible to wirelessly connect the C99 to your PC, as well as to other C99 boards for a wireless base rover system setup. It's also worth noting that there are a couple firmware options for the Odin module. It comes factory programmed with a firmware built specifically for evaluating C99 F9P. The firmware is built with ARM embed and provides a command line menu-based approach to setting up the wireless connectivity. It's also possible, however, to load the uBlox AT commands firmware called uConnect Express and set up the connectivity through AT commands. Finally, if you're really adventurous, it's also possible to write your own firmware from scratch using ARM embed. So in addition to the board, the C99 F9P kit includes a quick start card. Depending on the region where the kit was purchased, it may include a trial license to the Hexagon SmartNet Correction Service. There is a USB cable, a USB power cable, some jumpers, a Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antenna, a uBlox ANMB multi-band active GNSS antenna, and a ground plane disc. The ground plane disc is used with the GNSS antenna, just like this. So in this video, I'm first going to show how to connect the C99 F9P to your PC over USB. And then we're going to go through two different wireless rover examples. First, we'll configure the board as a wireless rover connectable over Bluetooth and test that. And then we will reconfigure the board for connectivity over Wi-Fi. So before we jump into the examples, let's take a closer look at the C99 F9P board hardware design. So taking a look at the board, we can see the Zed and Odin modules. There is an RF connection for each module. This one is for the Odin, this one's for the Zed. There are three push buttons. One is a board reset signal. One is used to put the Zed module into a bootloader mode. And one is used to reset the Odin configuration back to default. There is a USB connection, which goes to an onboard USB hub that is then connected to the native USB interface of the Zed module, as well as a USB to serial dual channel chip, which provides access to the UARTs of the Odin and the Zed module. In terms of powering the board, it can be powered over USB. It can also be powered from a DC barrel jack. And there's also a JST connector for a standard lithium battery. There's a charge circuit included, so when the battery is connected, it will be charged anytime either of the other two power sources are connected. There are status LEDs, three status LEDs for the GNSS, providing the time pulse, the RTK status, and the geofence status. There's one RGB LED providing the Odin status. It will change different colors depending on the state of the Odin. And there are two indicators related to the battery. One is a charge status that will be on anytime the battery is being charged. And there is also a reverse polarity warning light. So in case you happen to use a battery with the plus and minus connections reversed, that light will come on to warn you. Finally, there are some Arduino form factor header pins in case you want to use the board with an Arduino shield. So that's the hardware. Let's get started with the examples. So to get started, First, connect the antennas. Bluetooth and Wi-Fi antenna to the Odin RF connector and GNSS antenna to the Z RF connector. Next, I'll place my antenna in the window. And finally, I'll connect the board to my PC over USB. The first time you connect the board to your PC, Windows will automatically download and install the drivers. Just be sure you have an internet connection. Once the drivers are installed, the C99 board will create three COM ports. One is a native USB connection to the Z module, one is a UART connection to the Z module, and one is a UART connection to the Odin module. So at this point, there's no additional setup to begin testing the C99 over USB. Let's see if I can connect to the Z module over USB and UART. I have USB on COM 6 and the UART on COM 26. So I open up UCenter and connect to COM 6. I see that I'm receiving data from the board, and in fact, the board has a fix right now, and as I would expect, the time pulse light is blinking. Now let's connect to the UART on COM 26. Also, on this interface, I'm receiving data. So next, let's reconfigure the board as a wireless rover connectable over Bluetooth. To do this, I'm going to follow section 6.2.2 in the Application Board User Guide. Now, to configure the Odin module, you need to communicate over the UART. So next, I'm going to open a terminal to the Odin module, which is COM27. The baud rate to use is 460/800 with 8 data bits, no parity, one stop bit, and no flow control. Once you connect to the port, if you hit enter, you will get a list of available commands. You can get details on the commands by sending /help/run. So the first thing we're going to do is set the board visible over Bluetooth. And to do that, we're going to use this command here, /bt_visible/run. Once I send that, I get a confirmation that the device is now visible. And what this means is that I can go into my PC's Bluetooth connections and scan and connect to the C99 board. Once the board is paired, you'll get two additional COM ports in the device manager, two standard serial over Bluetooth COM ports. Windows creates two COM ports, however, just one of them is carrying the Bluetooth data, so you may need to check each one to see which one has data on it. Let's test these ports in UCenter. I have COM 29 and COM 30. Let's try COM 29. I'm not getting any data over COM 29, so it must be COM 30. Let's try to connect to COM 30. And indeed, we're getting some data from the board. This time, it's coming in over Bluetooth. You'll also notice that the Odin status LED turns blue when I'm connected over Bluetooth. If I disconnect the COM port, the LED goes to a blinking red. If I reconnect, back to blue. So at this point, I haven't yet saved anything into the memory of the Odin module. So if I were to reset the board, like so, when it comes back up, it's going to be back to the default state. will not be connectable over Bluetooth. So to persistently configure the board for a Bluetooth connectivity, the command to use is this command here, /mim_store/run /bt(1). When I send this command, I get an acknowledgement that the settings were stored to flash. This time, if I reset the board, we can see it's in default state right now because the status is green. This time, if I reset the board, when it boots back up, it will boot up into Bluetooth connectivity mode. I see in the console here, it says the Bluetooth has been set visible, and I can again come here to UCenter and connect to COM30, and I'm still receiving data from the board. Now, I reset the board, so I lost my GNSS fix. So that's how to set the C99 board up as a wireless Bluetooth rover using Bluetooth serial port profile. Next, let's reconfigure the board for wireless connectivity over Wi-Fi. In this case, what we're going to do is we're going to configure the board to be a Wi-Fi access point with a UDP server. And when we connect to the Wi-Fi network from our PC and connect to the UDP port, the board will automatically start streaming data to the PC. So the first thing to do is restore the Odin module to default. We'll do that by holding down this button for at least 3 seconds. And then once you release it, wait at least another 3 seconds for the reset to take place. And then you can reset the board. I see in the console for the Odin, when it comes back up, this confirms it's still in the default state, or back to the default state, and the status LED is back to green. So to configure the C99 as a wireless rover connectable over Wi-Fi, I'm going to follow section 6.3.1.2 in the application board user guide. So there's just two commands to issue here. First, we need to persistently configure the board as a Wi-Fi access point. And to do that, we send the command /mim_store/run /Wi-Fi_AP. We get an acknowledgement that that was saved to flash. And there's one other setting to apply. /mim_store/run /rover. So now when we reset the C99 board one more time, it will boot up into the new configuration. We get some details about that here in the console. So what I can do next is connect my PC's Wi-Fi to the C99 access point. The default SSID is C099-F9P with a password of 12345678. Okay, I've just finished connecting my PC to the Wi-Fi access point provided by the C99. I can see that the status LED for the Odin has changed to a purple color. So the next step to communicate wirelessly with the Z module is to connect in UCenter to this UDP address and port. It's right here in the console output from the Odin. So if I open UCenter And when I go to select a port, I choose network connection. I can just create a new one, paste in the UDP address and port that I got from the Odin console. And as soon as I do that, I'm again receiving data from the Zed module. This time it's over a Wi-Fi connection and the data is being sent over UDP. So there you have it. I hope this intro helps you get started with your C99F9P. Let us know in the comments how you're planning to use your board. Also, stay tuned for more videos, including more ways to set up the C99F9P. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.